Hello everyone, welcome to my channel 212.com. The topic for today's discussion is equation of motion. We have already studied what is motion. We have discussed about speed, velocity, distance, displacement, acceleration, uniform acceleration, and how to plot graphs. So today we will be discussing about the three equations of motion and how to derive them graphically. So first is V equals U plus AT. Second is S equals UT plus half AT square. And third is 2AS equals V square minus U square. So here U is the initial velocity. V is my final velocity. S is the displacement of the object. A is the acceleration and T is the time taken. So initially, if I have a car which is moving and it reaches somewhere, so the velocity that the car initially had is zero. It could start from rest. So in that case, the velocity would be 0 meter per second. Or if you have any initial velocity that's mentioned, so that would be my U. My final velocity is when the time at which I consider my final velocity, the time difference between these two will give me my t, and the displacement that happens when the change in the velocity occurs will give me the displacement. Acceleration is the final and minus initial velocity divided the rate of the velocity, v minus u divided by time. So a is represented for acceleration and t is the time. Now let's check out the first equation. So the first equation that we have is a velocity time relation. So see, in the exam, if you ask for a proof, you first need to draw this graph. Let me first explain this graph. So this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis, this is my origin point. So on x I have my time, on y I have my velocity. Now this is the graph that I have, that AB. So At A, there you can see some value of the velocity. That means that the car has some initial velocity, and this gives me my initial velocity, which is u. At point B, where the car finally is at, I'll take my final velocity, and this total distance, the total value, is taken as the velocity or the final velocity. The time for this change for the graph, this is taken as t. I hope this part is clear to you. Now for this, what I'll do is, initially I have a graph like this. So initially you'll be drawing it like this, and the line is like this. Now what I'll do is that I'll draw a line which is perpendicular to the x-axis. Now the person has drawn AD, which is, I'll just change my this thing pointer so that it's easily viewable. So I have drawn this perpendicular, which is parallel to OC. That let's name it AD, and from this graph we'll have made another line which is perpendicular, and that's BC, and I have joined all these lines. So I've got a final graph, as you can see on the screen. Now what I'll do is, here I'll first see, first I need to find the acceleration. Now I know that the slope of a velocity time graph, it gives me acceleration, and acceleration is also the change in velocity divided by time taken. So my BC here, that is the final velocity, BC is equals BD plus DC. So for DC, I can replace it by OA because it's a rectangle, and we all know that the opposite sides of a rectangle are parallel and equal. So I have BC equals BD plus OA finally. Now I know that OA equals U, which is my initial velocity. And so I'll have my BC equals V and OA equals U. So I'll replace this BC, which is my final velocity, with V. I'll get V equals BD plus U. And that is how I'll get my BD as V minus U. Now the reason why we have found this BD is because I need to find the slope for triangle BDA. So for BDA, I need to find BD. That is why we have done this step. Now from the velocity time graph, the acceleration is change in velocity divided by time taken. So change in velocity is what? BD, because that is V minus U. V minus U will give me BD. I've already discovered it here. So BD divided by AD. Now for AD, I'll have it as OC, since it's a rectangle and the opposite sides are parallel and equal. So I'll have it as BD and OC. The reason why I've taken it as OC is because I know that OC is T. So now I'll replace this OC with time, and I'll get A equals BD divided by T. So finally, I can get BD as AT. because by cross connection, I'll have this t up, go up. So now I'll have the final value as BD equals 80. But we have already found out that BD equals V minus U. So that means that we got V equals U plus 80. Why? I'll have VD equals V minus U. So V minus U equals 80. That means V is equal to U plus 80. And that is how I get my final velocity time relation. I hope this part is clear to you. So velocity time relation is received by the slope of the graph. Now next, I have my position time graph. So for position, I have my x-axis and the y-axis. Let me just take a pen. So x-axis, y-axis. Now I have this as my U and this complete as my V, like initially I had. And this would be my T. Okay. So now I know that the area under the graph of a velocity time graph, it gives me displacement. So displacement is S. So I'll have the area of this B, C, O, and A as my this whole area as my area under the graph, which would be my displacement. So I'll just erase this because it will just create a chaos for you. So now continuing with this, the area would be the sum of this triangle plus the sum of this area of the rectangle. So for triangle, I have OA, that is the base. So first, the person has taken the area of the rectangle, that would be OA times OC, and then half times AD times BD would be the area of my triangle. So now replacing OA, now my OA is U and my OC is T and AD is T, and earlier I have already written that BD equals 80 in my previous slide. See, BD is equal to 80. So from all of that, I'll put it in this equation and I'll get my equation equals S is equal to UT plus half 80 square, which is my position time relation. I hope this part is clear to you. Next, continuing position velocity relation. Now I have taken this graph again. In this case, what I'll have is I'll take the area of the trapezium, that is OABC. Now it's similar to the one which was earlier. In this case, we are considering that this is a trapezium because in trapezium we have opposite parallel sides and two non-parallel sides. Here I have OA equals U, which I've been taking since earlier. This is my T and I have my BC as V. So we know that the area of trapezium is the sum of the parallel sides multiplied by the unparallel side divided by 2, by the distance between the two. So the two unparallel sides are OA and BC. So I'll add the two parallel side and I'll multiply it by the distance between the two and divide it by 2. So OA here is U, so I'll substitute it by U, BC is V and OC is T. So I'll get the value as T. Now from previous, I've already found out from my first equation, that is my velocity time relation, that V is equal to U plus 80. So what I'll do here is, just a second, I'll change the ink so that it's clear. So V equals U plus 80. That is my first equation. So from here, if I need to find T, I'll shift this here. So to shift, the signs will change. So I'll have V minus U, which will be equal to 80. And then I will, for to find A, I'll just move this A down in the denominator of V minus U. So this is my equation from velocity time relation. Now I'll substitute this value of T in the equation in place of this. So I'll have my final equation like this. Now we know the identity A plus B times A minus B will give me A square minus B square. So replacing A with V and B by U, I get A square minus B square, that is V square minus U square, and I'll do a crisscross, so I'll have my 2A shift in the numerator on the opposite side. So my final equation would be 2AS equals V square minus U square. I hope this part is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please do mention in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to reply back. And let's do a quick summarization of this. So there are three equations of motion. First is velocity time relation, which is V equals U plus 80. Second is position velocity relation, that is 2AS equals V square plus U square. That's what I thought. So this is not plus, this is actually minus v square minus u square. And I'll have position time relation, that is s equals ut plus half at square. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please write in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to reply. Please do subscribe and like our videos. Thank you so much. Have a great day.